I would love to hear your voice. Can I please hear your voice?
This is a story of a recent incident involving myself and another researcher experiencer friend of mine, LeeAnn. LeeAnn reached out to me several years ago regarding my experiences, and I helped her understand discerning Sasquatch activity through my own contact experience. LeeAnn's own research has consistently grown since we first met. She's accumulated possibly the biggest collection of Sasquatch-related structures in the world. We both use audio as a tool for learning Sasquatch behavior, something that our forest friends allow, showing a consistent presence at our audio recorders. Our research locations are several hours driving distance apart. LeeAnn also uses marbles for interacting. Audio recording has been my tool of choice, which has produced some incredible results that to this day are ignored by North American science involved in the subject of Sasquatch. Credentialed, unbiased forensic analysis on my audio recordings would show a lung capacity that goes well beyond human. I have a substantial amount of supporting evidence, including multiple witnesses to the activity. Even with the support of prominent science minds involved in this subject, the controversy surrounding my audio recordings stalls science from taking proper steps for analysis. Russian science, however, shows an unbiased awareness and acknowledges Sasquatch abilities. Sasquatch truth is an expansion of consciousness, a paradigm shift for humanity, connected to the ET-UFO subject, which would easily give reason for a massive cover-up. Ongoing contact experience gives each of us an insight into a much larger unseen existence that surrounds us, one that is filled with sentient life that is far evolved past our own existence. This truth changes everything. A beautiful part of all this is that neither government, military, or even science has the ability to control who our forest friends make contact with or how they choose to show their presence to the world. They want to connect with us and show us a better way that is symbiotic with nature, one that lives in balance with everything. They want us to wake up before it's too late. Everything is connected. Absolutely everything. On July 19th, I made a visit to the area Neff and family live, and I left 10 marbles as a gift. There were two larger than normal clear blue marbles that I liked, and I was going to keep them, but I ended up leaving them as a gift for Neff and family. What I've learned about Sasquatch behavior is that they know what you focus on. They'll put sign in front of your face where they know you'll see it, moments that will leave you scratching your head. This is consistent with their activity and interactions. Neff and family knew I wanted those marbles, and I'm sure they appreciated that I chose to instead leave them as a gift. I was alone, I told nobody what I was doing. I don't normally film leaving gifts, but for some reason I did turn on the video camera that time, sitting it down beside me. I went back on August 7th, and 8 of the 10 marbles were gone. I checked the forest floor to see if any had fallen or been knocked off. Nothing. They were all gone. Looking back at a previous experience, when visiting the cottage with Dwayne, I was given 14 birthday candles, one at a time, throughout the night. It was August the 9th, 2013. They knew what a birthday was. Some of the candles were witnessed manifesting out of thin air, an ability that the Sasquatch have consistently shown me, making objects appear from thin air. The past 5 years of contact have been consistent with showing a constant progression, always giving something new. They're great teachers who are giving a slow reveal of the greater unseen existence that surrounds us. Their activity, for the most part, is subtle yet blatant. I've been given the gift of learning their behavior and activity and how they interact with us. It's been very consistent over the past 5 years, and the same with others I've dealt with who have their own contact situations. On August 7th, 8 of the marbles were gone. On August 9th, LeeAnn called to wish me a happy birthday and mentioned that the night before, four blue marbles she had put out had disappeared. She then mentioned that she found a clear blue crystal boulder inside a tree stump that she uses for her research and interactions. I said, "Crystal boulder? What's that?" LeeAnn then mentioned that it was a name she used when she was younger to describe a larger marble. I immediately thought about the two identical larger clear blue marbles that went missing from my last visit. At this point, she still knew nothing about them. I hadn't told her yet. I suddenly got excited, thinking, could it be one of the missing marbles that I'd given as a gift? The thought stunned me. I told her about the missing pair of clear blue marbles that I'd put out as a gift at my location, and I asked her to take a picture and send it to me with a regular size marble next to it to show size comparison. It was the same. I then mentioned to LeeAnn to keep an eye open for a second one, as I put out two identical clear blue marbles, exactly like the one that appeared at her gifting spot. She messaged me a short time later, realizing that she'd already been given the second one. It had appeared 2 days prior in the same spot as the one that appeared and was found on August 9th. Lee thought that maybe the first one was one she'd left out long ago that she'd missed, but she never recalled putting out any clear blue marbles that looked like that. They're distinct in the fact that they're larger than regular size and that there was an identical pair of them in the same bag. The timing fits that they appeared at her location after the ones I'd left had gone missing from my location. Neither of us were aware of each other's activity until we'd spoken to each other when she called on August the 9th. Considering the many times I've experienced marbles and other objects appearing from thin air directly related to Sasquatch presence, I'm confident that these are the same two marbles that had disappeared from my location and ended up appearing at LeeAnn's location where similar activity has gone on. An incredible display showing Sasquatch interdimensional abilities and the connection between two people involved doing the same research. It's a consistent teaching showing us incidents that are related to the natural laws that govern the universe. Sasquatch are revealing their existence through small gestures that give insight into the unknown. There's overwhelming evidence supporting the existence of interdimensional intelligence that have been making contact with humans for thousands of years. There's been a massive cover-up that I believe is coming to an end. To lend more support to the aspect that these beings have interdimensional qualities, Ronnie LeBlanc, who wrote the book Monsterland, did an interview with me over the phone. The interview is published in Chapter 17, where he reveals some strange activity that happened after we spoke on the phone. Ronnie's intention was to learn if there was a connection between orbs, UFOs, and Bigfoot. He asked me advice on how to gain interaction with Sasquatch. I told him, have pure thoughts, that they know your intent, and that you can even make contact from home. A few weeks later, Ronnie went for a forest hike in Leominster State Forest. On his way back to his car, he kept thinking about the talk we'd had about the marbles. It was a few days later when he was at home cleaning the front yard and he was out doing some gardening along the driveway. He went back to the spot he was planning to mulch and did a quick check to make sure that the area was clear of rocks and weeds. The last spot he cleared was to be his starting point, and he made a mental note. He left to go get a bag of mulch a few yards up the driveway, and literally within a few seconds, when he came back to the same spot, there it was, a marble. It was sitting in the middle of the area, right there on top of the dirt. It wasn't there before. It was a blue, yellow, and clear marble, right where he was about to start the mulch. Ronnie was stunned. He couldn't believe his eyes. He quickly brought it inside to his office, and he put it on a shelf where it wouldn't be disturbed. He even put a book in front of it so that nobody would move it, and he went back to work thinking, no way, how the hell did that just happen? Ronnie woke up the next morning, it was May 8th, and he suddenly remembered the marble. He went to retrieve it from his office and was shocked a second time. It wasn't the same marble that he'd put there. The very next day, he went to his parents' house to help move some furniture. As Ronnie and his dad were walking to the front door from the garage, his dad, who was in front, stopped. He said, "Look out, there's a marble right there. Not sure how that got there." Ronnie got goosebumps. His father continued into the house, and as Ronnie walked through the door, he looked down and stopped dead in his tracks. Wedged between the doormat and the step plate in the center was a blue and clear marble. That weekend, he had some family over for a cookout. Ronnie and his wife cleared an area for a fire pit. During the middle of their conversation, she looks down and sees an orange marble just sitting on top of the dirt. She yells over to Ronnie to come quick. He reaches down, picks it up. It's clean as a whistle. It seemed that it was placed there, not dug up from the dirt. She looks at him amazed with her eyes widening and swears to God that it wasn't there a minute ago. She states that she was looking in Ronnie's direction and then looks back and it was just there. It just appeared out of nowhere. There are many involved in this subject who have a difficult time accepting that this enigma involves abilities that delve into quantum physics, that Sasquatch have interdimensional capability. Ronnie LeBlanc is one of several folks that I've spoken with over the phone or had discussions with that suddenly experience activity. There's been enough incidents to note that I'm being watched and listened to by an unseen, highly evolved intelligence that is reaching out and exposing their existence to us. The Sasquatch have a wonderful way of exposing themselves, giving us our own personal proof of not only their existence, but how highly evolved and intelligent they are. Despite many thinking they're a monster or something to be feared, my personal experiences, as well as those from numerous others I've dealt with, all show the same loving and compassionate approach. I've had numerous telepathic incidents, with one being a vision given to me with words that were felt. I didn't hear them verbally, but the clarity of what was conveyed was undeniable. It also explained to me how they could likely understand any language, that words did not have to be verbally spoken to be understood. The words I felt were clearly understood. It's been roughly 29 months since I was told by our forest friends, "Soon your people will know." Those words followed an image that was placed in my mind of dozens of Sasquatch all walking in the same direction across an open meadow. It lasted several seconds, short and to the point. I'm convinced we're on the cusp of a great reveal that will soon be shown to the world that there is much more going on around us that has always been there. Contact with non-human higher intelligence. This is a piece of video footage I took while leaving the 10 marbles on my July 19th visit. In this video clip, I state June 19th, but it's actually July 19th. It's about 6:30 p.m. June 19th. A little walk here. My little gifting spot. This is some dark chocolate that I usually do. I need my audio there. Yet a who? Marbles and some dark chocolate. one piece for me. Mosquitoes out. And marbles. All right, my friends. Gonna take the video camera with me. All right. Some dark chocolate in my audio recorder. I've got my tent set up for the night. Sasquatch have the ability to show up at your audio recorder without a sound. All of a sudden, they're just there, and they'll let you know through stick breaking, rock clacks, mimicked animal sounds, or it could be as simple as an exhale breath right next to the audio mic. It's done purposely just to let you know they're present. They'll sometimes hang around the audio recorder all night, giving indications throughout of their presence. They're always full of surprises. LeeAnn's YouTube channel link is in the description under this video. She's documented literally hundreds of structures and is doing some great work making strides in contact with our forest friends.
We love you.
That's very nice.
We love you. What?